Welcome back to the Northwoods Family Channel. Thanks for joining us. We get a lot of questions about the tires and wheels we put on our machine and why we went this route, especially when it comes to our overlanding adventures. For over 2,000 miles now, we've been running these Tusk Terrabite Tires and Tusk Teton Beadlock Rims, and I'm going to give you a rundown on them now. Tires are often the first thing that people want to replace as soon as they get a machine. Most UTVs are going to come from the factory with what is called a bias ply tire. Now, there are a ton of YouTube videos on the differences between bias ply and radial tires, so I'm not going to get into all the features, but I'll mention a few things that may help you decide what tire is best for your application. Because of the way bias ply tires are constructed, they do have some advantages over radials in certain areas. First of all, they are quite a bit less expensive, which is always nice. The sidewalls are stiff, which provides good puncture resistance in the sidewalls, so that can be nice for, you know, traveling over areas where you have sharp, jagged rocks, but it also makes your ride feel a little more bumpy. A bias ply tire flexes more across the tread than radials. This can help clear mud from the treads, but it also means that when you're cornering, especially on pavement, your tire tends to roll up more onto the sidewall, which means less of your tread is in contact with the ground, and it makes your machine feel less stable. Bias ply tires are easier to patch than radials, as evidenced by the dozen or so plugs that I have in my Ranger tires currently. Radials are constructed a little differently. The most obvious feature is the woven steel belt that runs radially around the tire along the tread. This gives the tire a more stable design, keeping more of the tire's footprint in contact with the road. This gives you more traction and a more stable, smoother ride. It reduces noise and heat buildup in the tire, and it leads to a longer tire life. The sidewall flexes up and down more, which smooths out bumps and again helps keep more of the tire tread in contact with the road. At the end of the day, I have found that the bias ply tires that we are running on our Ranger, they work great for operating at lower speeds, doing more utility work, crawling over logs, in really nasty mud and stuff like that. But for high horsepower, faster machines, I think the radials really provide a better riding experience and better performance. And that's exactly why we chose to pick up some radial tires for our General. Especially riding with the family for longer distances, especially if you know you're going to be on hard surfaces or pavement, you want that ride to be as comfortable as possible. A harsh, loud ride for long periods of time is going to wear on you as a driver, and it's going to make your family enjoy their time in the side-by-side a lot less. Trust me, maybe after a windshield, picking up a set of radial tires is probably the best thing you can do to improve your family's enjoyment in the UTV. All right, so we looked at a variety of radial tires, and we chose the Tusk Terrabites because they had good reviews. They appeared to be a good all-purpose tire for the type of riding we would be doing. We ordered the tires and rims at the same time from Rocky Mountain ATV, and they mounted them up for us for free, which was pretty cool, before they sent them off. The Terrabites themselves are an 8-ply tire, essentially meaning there are 8 layers of rubber that go into the construction of the tire. They are also DOT approved, which, depending on the state you live in, that might be important. Generally speaking, the higher the ply number, the tougher and more puncture resistant the tire is going to be. However, it also means that the tire is going to be heavier and more expensive. There are 10-ply and even 12-ply tires available, but I thought the 8-ply would be sufficient to provide the level of durability we were looking for. The tread pattern on the Terrabites is similar to what you would see in an aggressive truck tire. Large spaces between the lugs to help clear out mud and debris, but plenty of flat surfaces on the tread that provide grip on asphalt or other hard surfaces. The tires are non-directional, so they can be installed either way, and the inner and outer sidewalls have tread on them to help grip on rocks or other objects when navigating rough terrain. Now, a lot of people want to bump up their tire size right away. We chose to stick with the factory tire size because we weren't that familiar with our machine yet and we wanted to see how it performed, especially on the low end, knowing that we would be carrying heavy loads up steep terrain. Of course, we learned after a while our General has plenty of low end power, so bumping up a size or two in tires is something we might consider in the future, just for that additional ground clearance and potentially smoother ride going over some rocks. We also decided to get wider tires in the rear than the front tires, again, sticking with the factory sizes. We decided to do this because a wider tire can provide more stability and better load distribution when the cargo area is loaded up. The disadvantage, of course, is that you are stuck with rear tires in the rear and front tires on the front. If you have the same size tires on all four corners, you can rotate them like you would with a car to increase tread life. For a spare tire, we simply purchased another tire that matched the front size so we could put that tire anywhere it was needed. So now that you have a rundown of these tires themselves, you probably want to know how they performed because this is supposed to be a review, right? Well, so far I'm really happy with them. I would definitely buy them again. They are excellent on pavement, and regardless of where we wind up riding, we generally have long stretches of pavement we have to travel between trails, or sometimes we just go out for a ride on our local road routes, and the radial tires make a huge difference on the roads. The road noise and harshness on hard surfaces, it's significantly reduced over the bias ply tires. With the bias ply, there is a vibration that comes from the tires that after a while, it can be quite fatiguing, especially at higher speeds. But on our Black Hills trip, we were able to do stretches on pavement of 30 or more miles at a time at 65 miles per hour, and the ride was pretty good. I would not want to do that on stock bias ply tires, especially with the family. Cornering on pavement, even at higher speeds, the Terrabites feel so much more stable and hooked up to the pavement than our factory bias ply tires. You know, with the stock tires, you definitely feel the roll of the tire more, and you can tell there is less rubber in contact with the road. The Terrabites have done well in the mud. Now, we aren't mudders. We don't go looking for the biggest mud holes, but as we have needed to pass through thicker, deeper mud, the tires have done their job, getting us traction and clearing out mud from the tread. We have only ever been stuck once in our machine, and that was because we high-centered on a really deep, muddy rut. I don't think our tire choice there, maybe aside from running a much larger tire, would have helped us out. On rocky terrain, the tires have done really well. We went over a lot of rocks on our Black Hills trip and a few other places we've been. I feel the tread pattern puts more rubber in contact with the terrain, and it really helps grip the rocks and pull our machine up over them. Traversing down steep drop, just creeping the machine forward an inch at a time, the tires have held on to the rocks really good, not slipped, allowing us to control our descent and just gently set the machine down. We're certainly not rock crawlers, but we've gone over some pretty gnarly terrain for this type of machine, and it's worked pretty good so far. A couple of weekends ago, we finally had the chance to run these tires in the snow. This is where I had my doubts at first. That said, we were able to move along a flat terrain in about 8 inches of what I would call medium density snow without any problems or a significant amount of wheel slip. I was pretty impressed. At a certain point now, tread pattern isn't going to matter anymore because your machine is going to wedge so much snow up underneath it, the tires just won't have enough weight on them to grip the ground. At this point, even chains won't help you. Which brings me to my last point. The one area where I wasn't able to test these tires yet has been hard-packed snow and ice. Frankly, you know, I don't expect them to perform any worse than the stock tires that come with the machine. Again, not that the stock tires are bad, just my experience plowing for a decade with my Ranger using bias ply tires. Sometimes they slip, but overall they seem to do fine. At the end of the month, we do have some plans to ride some groomed winter trails up in northern Wisconsin, so we'll see how those trail conditions are, and I'll get you an update then. As I mentioned earlier, we put over 2,000 miles on these tires. We've hit some bumps and terrain really hard, square on the tires, smashed the sidewalls, you name it. We've had zero punctures, haven't thrown any beads. They've held up really well so far. I do currently have one tire that is leaking a little bit from the inside bead. It's on one of the rear rims. I pulled it off the rim, I cleaned the rim, I cleaned the tire, I reinstalled it, and I still have a small leak there. I need to pull the tire off and look at it again. It started after our 650-mile Black Hills overlanding trip, so I don't think I can blame the tire. I gotta take a closer look. It could still be a piece of gravel or something in the bead that I missed, but I might just need to remount it and maybe use some bead sealer to make sure that it patches up that leak. As for tread wear, they seem to be wearing at a reasonable rate. Tusk advertises the lugs at 3/4 of an inch deep. I'm not sure how they measure that. When I measured the lugs on our spare tire, which has never contacted the ground, my caliper reads 0.65 inches, a tenth of an inch less than advertised. That may not be a big deal. Maybe there's some tire measurement system I'm not doing correctly. Whatever. Measuring our rear tires after 2,000 or so miles, the tread depth is about 44 hundredths of an inch, and the front tires is exactly at half an inch. So I feel for the type of riding we do, we probably have another 2,000 or so miles in these tires. You know, we don't do a lot of mudding and things like that, so I think we'll be able to wear them down, you know, fairly low. Most likely, I'm thinking I'm going to have to replace them toward the end of next year after we've got 4,000 or 5,000 miles on them. For side-by-side tires, I don't think that's bad. Finally, the rims. The Tusk Tetons we ordered are real beadlock rims. Now, beadlocks, they certainly look cool, but they do require a little extra work. You have to check the torque on all the bolts from time to time, and you have to torque them down in a specific order. The advantage of the beadlocks is they will hold the tire on better, especially if you air down your tires for extra traction while navigating certain types of terrain. I figured, so far correctly, that the beadlocks would make it easier for me to take a tire on and off at home so I can replace tires by myself and not have to pay someone to do it, or it should make resetting the bead on the trail a little bit easier if necessary. So that pretty much wraps it up for a look at our Tusk Terrabite tires after 2,000 miles. As I said, we've been really pleased with them. They've held up well and performed great over a variety of different terrain conditions, at high speeds, low speeds, hauling heavy weight, you name it. They were reasonably priced and definitely a tire I would buy again. If you have any more questions about our tire setup or anything else on our general, go ahead and pop that in the comments below. We're always looking for options and ways to improve our riding experience too. So if you have a tire recommendation, let us know. Or if you've run these Terrabites yourself, we'd be interested in hearing about your machine, your setup, and your experience with them. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, we'd love it if you hit that subscribe button and be sure to check out our other videos of our side-by-side adventures from the last year. Ride safe, and we'll see you next time.